What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another car vlog. Today we're going to be talking about cryptocurrency and some of the strategies that I'm taking going into 2021. Now, I've been through two bubbles. Yes, two bubbles. So I went through the 2013 bubble where prices went all the way up to like $1,200, just about 1200 bucks, all the way back down to 190 bucks or maybe even a little bit lower than that. And then obviously into December 2017, prices went all the way up to $20,000. And a lot of new money, a lot of new retail traders came in during that time. And I'm assuming a lot of people were making money. Obviously going into 2018, a lot of people were losing money. And people found themselves in quite the predicament into 2018, and I kind of wanted to talk about some of the tax strategies that I wish I kind of understood back in the day. And before I get into all that, obviously I am not a tax advisor, I am not a CPA, I'm not a financial advisor. Please do your own research. Please contact a CPA that understands cryptocurrency, capital gains, and in terms of short-term capital gains, long-term capital gains. I personally use a tax advisor through Token Tax, and I will link a referral down below, and you can sign up with Token Tax, and they have all sorts of different plans. This is not sponsored by them in any way. I'm just literally trying to hook you guys up with someone who, a company that actually understands the tax law in the United States. So please just keep that in mind. This is not tax advice. This is just what I've been doing. So in 2017, December 2017, we hit the all-time high. A lot of people were trading back and forth between altcoins and Bitcoin. So if you are completely new to how to tax cryptocurrency, there's some general rules that you need to be aware of. When you're buying Bitcoin with US dollars, that is not a taxable event. You simply take your US dollars, you go and you purchase Bitcoin, Coinbase, whatever exchange, that is not a taxable event. It is when you sell that Bitcoin back into US dollars, that is when you have a taxable event and you need to pay capital gains. If you sell your Bitcoin to an altcoin, it doesn't matter what altcoin it is, that is also a taxable event. So I think there was a lot of confusion back in the day. Bitcoin to altcoin trades, people thought that they were like kind trades, meaning that because Ethereum is a cryptocurrency, we'll use Ethereum to Bitcoin as an example. Because Ethereum is a cryptocurrency and Bitcoin's a cryptocurrency, if you trade those two back and forth, because they are like kind, it's not a taxable event. That is actually wrong. The IRS states, and go to the irs.gov for all this information, that when you trade back and forth between cryptocurrencies, that is a taxable event. So a lot of people in 2017 were trading altcoins to Bitcoin all the way up to the high. So what people didn't realize was they were cashing out significant gains at the high in 2017. And then when the new year came, they had to pay a huge tax bill, and then the market crashed. So let's say you made $1 million in 2017, and then you held on to an altcoin position in 2018 all the way until like mid-2018. You had to pay taxes in April on $1 million gain, but you only had maybe $200,000 left in your account. So if you kind of do the math, $1 million in income, short-term capital gains, that means that you're in a tax bracket of about 37%, and add on another, let's say 7 to 9%, depending on what state you're in. It's literally impossible to pay that tax bill. So a lot of people actually got into debt, even though they made a significant amount of money in 2017 and still had a decent chunk of change towards 2018, they still had to pay capital gains on that $1 million that they made. So kind of translating that into now, right now it is December of 2020. It's kind of weird to say that actually, because 2020 went by so quick. But we're kind of entering into that same type of scenario. No, we're not going parabolic like we were in December of 2017. But the price of Bitcoin has gone up significantly. And if you have been trading between altcoin and Bitcoin this whole time, you're going to have quite the taxable bill at the end or towards April of 2021. So please keep this in mind. You have to take some of your cash and you have to reserve it to pay your taxes. And the reason why I am actually making this video is because I have been personally audited by the IRS for cryptocurrency gains, and I will totally break down that entire experience if you want to know what that was like. If you haven't paid your taxes on cryptocurrency gains, it doesn't mean that you can't anymore. Like, you can still amend your cryptocurrency 1040 or 8949 form. We can get into that later, but if you are someone who thinks that you owe money on taxes from previous tax years, definitely talk to a CPA. You can contact Token Tax down below. They will help you out. They'll help you get an amended return and make sure all of your transactions are sorted out correctly, because let's be honest, it is really, really, really difficult, especially back in the day when you were trading, moving funds around to different exchanges, and you might have some missing data in there that might not translate into the correct correct gain, whether you might even be reporting too much. It's always good to just double check because cryptocurrency is so new. But if you guys want to hear about that experience, definitely leave a comment down below. I think I pretty much ran a poll on Twitter, and a lot of people were really interested in that. And I wanted to make a video on that, but let's see what you guys want to hear about. Let's see what you guys want to see on my channel. So, so just keep that in mind, guys. You want to be very mindful of going into next year and your tax bill. Now, just real quick, I'm gonna end the video in just a moment here, but if you were holding on to a position longer than a year, that is long-term capital gains. If you're holding a position for less than a year, it is short-term capital gains. You can check your tax bracket on irs.gov, and you can also look at your local government website, local state website, to see what tax that you would accrue in your state. So I just wanted to just give you a heads up on that, guys. Definitely leave a comment. Like I said, leave a comment down below. Tell me what you guys think. Do you have a specific strategy that you take? My personal strategy has just been to HODL at this point in time. I want to pay long-term capital gains as much as possible, so holding on to a position longer than a year. So pretty much throughout 2020, I was just HODLing. I really was not trading all that much. I had a few trades, a few speculative trades back and forth, and I'll have to pay taxes on that, of course. But I'm pretty much just HODLing at this point. I think trading less ultimately turns into higher, more profits over time, especially with cryptocurrency. So I'm going to end the video there, guys, and let me know what you guys think. Thanks for watching, and keep HODLing.